You work for Microsoft, one of the most dynamic companies in the world, but there's a lot you probably don't know about this place. So let's do some Microspotting. This is the Microsoft Archive. We're here with Amy Stevenson, who is the archivist for Microsoft. Let's start with these chairs that we're sitting on. Where did they come from?
So these chairs were Bill's chairs. They were his conversation chairs in his office back in the early 80s.
You're the one deciding the history of Microsoft in terms of what gets preserved?
Yeah, it's a pretty important job. There's a couple different ways we look at things. So some things are interesting for exhibit value because they're going to look cool. They're going to cause somebody to have a reaction to them later on.
Right. Something like this.
Something like those skulls, yeah. So it embodies the culture of Microsoft.
Yes, I mean, you look at this and you just think, Microsoft.
Sometimes there's something that comes in that I'm really just not sure about. Something might come up in the meantime, a research question, that suddenly that thing is super important and I had no idea before.
Do you ever like break these out when you're feeling kind of stumped and you want to just like get a little jolt of creativity?
This is the first time I've ever sat in these chairs.
How are you feeling?
You made me do it.
Highly creative?
Slightly guilty.
Why do you think it's important for Microsoft to actually have all this stuff?
We're saving things that are really important culturally to the world. And I think we're doing a pretty good job here of saving not just the software on the disks, but everything around the software. So the marketing, how we advertised it, what was important about it, the documentation about how the developers did things, the tools they used.
Smells like archiving. Do you guys have any old hardware stuff we can check out?
This is our largest piece of hardware in the collection. It's actually a server system from Windows server launch for Windows Server 2003. This was actually on stage with Steve Ballmer. We have a great picture of him in front of it. And this was a brand new computer in 2003. It was worth at least $1 million.
What do you think it's worth now?
Less? Zero.
I have bad news too. The ice maker's broken.
This is one of my favorite pieces. It's not the original Altair that we built our company around, but it's the next edition of it. So this came out in about 1978.
I'm just rebooting it here.
I see you already know how to use it.
I need to send an email to 1982.
Good luck with that.
This is good. You're a professional. Why did Microsoft ever get rid of this bitchin' logo? This looks like Microsoft is playing a stadium in New Jersey on Sunday, and all you metalheads want to be there. And this is the piece de resistance, right?
Do you recognize them?
Kind of.
So this is Clippy, also known as Clip-It, and he got to be on stage with Bill Gates, too.
This Clippy?
Well, it could be that Clippy.
I thought that one looked a little cooler, actually.
When office people retire, they check Clippy out for the party a lot.
Really? Has it ever come back reeking of tequila?
No.
Well, listen, Amy Stevenson, thank you so much for having us back here. It's been very informative. Next time we're here, I want to know what's going on with that Bill Gates painting. I think its eyes are following me. Did you know Bill Gates was a dropout?
Yeah. We have his transcripts from Harvard.
Wait, you have his transcripts here?
Yeah.
Can we look at them?
No.